Hey all, Chris here from LlamAcademy, here to help you make your game dev dream become a reality. I'm really excited to share that I have just released a 21 plus hour course on how to make a real-time strategy game with Unity 6. I did this in partnership with Game Dev TV, and I'm so excited to finally be able to get this in your hands. This video is actually directly from the course, not this part, but the main content part. So you can see how to implement a top-down camera movement using Cinemachine in Unity 6 with the new input system. This will give you a sneak peek at the teaching style and give you a little bit of feel for how the course will go. In this course, you're going to learn all the frameworks that you need to make your very own real-time strategy game. From unit configurations, to buildings, to actions per unit, to complex behavior trees, to tech trees, to fog of war, all of this is covered in the course. RTS games are very complex to build. I would say they're one of the most complex types of games to build and balance, just the whole thing. There's a lot of complexity that goes into it. And there's not as much educational content on how to make one. So I thought this was gonna be a really awesome concept. Anyway, let's get into this lecture. I hope you enjoyed this direct footage from the course. In this lecture, we're going to set up the top-down keyboard movement so we can move the camera around by using the up, down, left, and right arrow keys. This is one of the multiple ways that we're going to control moving the camera around. Let's get started. We're going to be using the new input system, which really isn't very new. It was first introduced with Unity 2018 as a preview package, and I think 2019 is when it was fully released. This new input system has scripting APIs for both polling input, that's where we check every frame, whatever we want to see, is it this button was pressed, released, or is it still pressed? It also has an event-driven way of receiving input. That's where we receive a callback when any input is received. So as soon as I press a button, we'll get an event raised. Usually when we're dealing with the new input system, most people are using the event-driven method. However, for the simplicity of understanding, we're going to be using the polling method in this course. If you have used the old input system, this will be very familiar to you. The new input system APIs we're going to use are keyboard, which provides polling and on-demand key press support for the keyboard, similar to the old input.getKey APIs. The other important one is mouse, which provides similarly polling and on-demand access to the current mouse position and mouse clicks. This is similar to the input mouse position in input.getMouseButton up, down, or just getMouseButton APIs from the old input system. Let's hop over to Unity and get started with our base setup. Over here in Unity, we need to create our new script. So let's go down to our project panel, and because we're going to have a lot of scripts, let's make sure that we stay organized. In our scripts folder, let's create a new folder called player, and just right-click in there to create a new script. Right-click, create, and if you've not used Unity 6 before, you'll notice that this menu looks very different than it did before. It's a lot more organized and sorted alphabetically. At the top, we have mono behavior script. Let's go ahead and click on that and make a new script called player input. We just double click that to open up this script in VS Code. All right, and in our class here, we're gonna need to add a few references. Let's start with our Cinemachine target with a serialized field, private transform camera target. This is just gonna be that transform that we're gonna move around to move that Cinemachine camera. I don't think we need start right now. Let's go ahead and remove that. And most of what we're going to do is probably going to need to be here in update. Let's go ahead and mark that private. We don't want somebody else to call this function. What we want to do is move this transform, this camera target, based on if the player is pressing up, down, left, or right. That means we can move in two axes, the world Z and the world X. Let's make a vector 2 move amount, and we'll assign it to be vector 2, 0 by default. And what we want to do is just check if the keyboard up arrow is pressed. We can do that simply by if, and this is where the new input system comes in, keyboard from the Unity Engine input system, namespace, perfect. Then we have current, which tells us we're going to use the current keyboard, great. Then we have the up arrow key, great. Then we can check, is it up? Was it released? A bunch of stuff here. We're just going to check is pressed. And that returns us a Boolean. So that's perfect. That's almost exactly the words I just used to say what I want to happen. Then we can say move amount.y plus equals some number. How much should we move? Well, we didn't define that. It's probably something we want to tweak in the inspector. So let's go ahead and come back up here to the top and say a private serialized float keyboard pan speed. I'll assign that to 5 by default. We'll see if that's a good value or not once we get into the editor. So back down here in our update, our if statement, we're going to add that keyboard pan speed to our move amount Y. So great, now we can move straight up. We're on the positive Z axis in world space, but we can potentially press more than one button at the same time. I could be pressing up and left at the same time. So we don't want to do an else if here, we just want to do another if. So we can simply check if keyboard.current.left arrow key dot is pressed. And what are we going to do there? We're going to go left on the X axis. So that's going to be move amount dot X minus equals keyboard pan speed. And this is where I'd like to introduce this lecture's challenge. Implement the down arrow key and the right arrow key press to move the camera if either of these buttons are pressed. So go ahead, pause the video, implement that down and the right arrow key press, and I'll see you back in a couple minutes. All right, welcome back. I hope you're able to solve that. Let's go ahead and go through it together right now. We've already done up and left. We're going to basically do the same thing here for down and right. I'm going to copy paste this because there's a lot of typing and I'm relatively lazy here. We said we want to do down arrow key and right arrow key. And for down, that's going negative on the Y. So we'll make sure to minus equal keyboard pan speed. That way, if we're pressing up and down at the same time, we've zeroed out our move amount Y. And the same on X for right arrow key, we're going to do plus equals the keyboard pan speed on the X. So if you did that, great job. If you didn't, I hope it makes sense now that we've gone through it together. We're not done yet though. We've just assigned a vector to move amount. We now need to take that move amount and move our camera target based on this move amount. So let's go ahead and go down a little bit more and say camera target dot position, because we're going to manipulate the position, plus equals a new vector 3. And we're just going to remap that X and Y to X and Z with move amount dot X, saying 0 for the Y. We're not going to manipulate the Y position, and remap our move amount Y to the world Z. That way we're moving on that flat XZ plane, not moving up and down at all. But remember, we're in our update function, so we need to make sure that we scale this move amount by the time dot delta time. Do you know how to do that? With a vector 2, that's quite easy. We can just do move amount times equals time dot delta time. That way, we're sure that this movement amount and this keyboard pan speed is consistent regardless of the frame rate. That should be everything we need to make the keyboard movement working. Let's take a look at it back over in the Unity editor. Let's select our main camera and attach that script player input, and make sure to select our script, not this thing that comes from the new input system. So we need this camera target to be hooked up. Let's grab our camera target transform, drag it to that reference right there. Let's click play and see how it works. Cool. As I press left, it goes left, up goes up, and go up and right, or even down and right. I press left and right at the same time, we don't move. Up and down at the same time, we don't move. This does feel a little bit slow to me. If we up that to 10, it's a little bit faster. Maybe I'll even go 15. Usually the keyboard moving is a little bit faster than the mouse, so I think this is a good starting point. Remember to exit play mode and set that back to 15. That's all for this lecture. We've learned about the new input system, keyboard APIs, and used it with the player input to give us a nice way to pan around using the keyboard. When you're ready, I'll see you on the next lecture, where we'll continue to use the new input system to refine our player input. I hope you got a lot of value out of this video and you're able to see how you can do that top-down movement using Cinemachine and the new input system, and also got a good feel for how the course is going to be taught. I've got an affiliate link down in the description if you want to check out this course. Again, it's more than 21 hours long, covering all the frameworks that you need to build an RTS. If you've been getting value out of this channel, this is a tremendous way for you to show your support while still getting over 21 hours of video content on how to make an RTS game. Other ways you can show your support: you can get yourself some LlamAcademy merch right here on YouTube. You can become a YouTube member or a Patreon supporter. That'll get you access to a private members exclusive Discord, as well as recognition on every video. Starting at the awesome tier, you'll get shout out like these awesome folks: Ivan, Ifiabolus, Jason Hansen, Sneddon, Trey Briggs, Will B, Mustafa, Nick5454, and Pixel Wizards. And of course, there's also all of these great supporters as well. Thank you all for your support, and I'll see you on the next video.